Hi everyone, welcome to Cryptomarket, the educational channel about Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies. Today, we are going to look at step-by-step how to use the Phantom Wallet. I'm going to show you its main features, and I'm also going to make some transactions to show you how it works. Before starting, remember that Cryptomarket has the Crypto Project Report service, in which you can receive very valuable information about new projects that are launched on the market. In the description, you will find a link to the video where you will find more information about the service. Phantom is the most popular wallet in the Solana ecosystem. It is very pleasant to use and has very interesting features. Previously, it was a wallet that only used the Solana network. And in recent months, they have made some very interesting updates. For example, it already has support for the Ethereum and Polygon networks, and they have just added the Bitcoin network. And additionally, the wallet can now be linked with the Ledger Nano X wallet. I'm going to start by downloading the wallet. You go to the official website. In the description of the video, I am going to leave you the web address of the Phantom Wallet so you can enter directly and safely. Remember to save this address in bookmarks. The wallet is available as an extension for browsers and is also available for iOS and Android mobile devices. The mobile and browser wallet setup process is very similar. So in this video, I'm going to show you the wallet for browsers. I am going to install the wallet in Chrome. To get started, you can create a new wallet or you can import an existing wallet. I am going to create a new wallet. So, the first thing you should do is create a very strong password. You must enter this password every time you go to enter the wallet. But, it is important to clarify that this password is not part of the recovery phrase, they are totally different. Here you enter it, and here you confirm it. You accept the terms and continue. And now, the secret recovery phrase appears. Remember that these words are the most important thing when you create a wallet. These words allow you full access to the wallet and all funds. And it is the only way to recover your wallet if you have lost access to it. You should save them in a safe place, never on a USB, never on a computer, and even less take photos with your smartphone or upload them to the cloud. When you finish copying the words, confirm here and that's it. And the message appears that you can now use your wallet. When you open the wallet, the first thing you find are the available networks. If you go to this icon at the top left, you will find the default account and you can see the address of each network. In this icon at the bottom, you can make some settings. In preferences, you can change the language. And you can also choose the Solana Explorer that you like the most. And below, you can choose the type of Bitcoin address you want to use. You can choose between SegWit or Taproot. I am going to keep SegWit activated. In security and privacy, you can change the password. And you can set the time for the wallet to be locked when you are not using it. I'm going to choose 5 minutes. You can leave these two options below activated, there is no problem. This is very interesting. Look that here in the active networks section, you can choose which networks you want to use. Here a button appears next to each one. So you simply turn off the one you don't like. So, if for example you want to use the wallet only with the Solana network, you can disable the other networks. For obvious reasons, you will not be able to deactivate the Solana network. For example, I don't like using Ethereum, so I'm going to disable it. This is very important. If you deactivate a network and suddenly you had a token in it, you do not lose anything because the token is not deleted. You can rest assured because you do not lose the token when you deactivate the network, it is simply hidden. And at any time, you can activate the network again, and the token appears. In the address book, you can add the ones you use the most. Here in connected applications, you can manage permissions. This is very important for the security of your funds. For example, if you connected to the Jupiter decentralized exchange to buy or sell a token. After using it, you come to this option and you can disconnect the wallet from that application. Never activate these automatic confirmations that appear here because they can put your funds at risk. Always confirm each operation yourself. For safety, I recommend that after using an application, you come to this section and disconnect it. Below, you can lock the wallet if you don't want to wait for it to lock automatically. And with a password, you unlock it. If you like this information, please give me a like and share the video so that other people can learn how to use this wallet. Let's continue. If you want to link this wallet with Ledger, you go to the Manage Account section and select Add or Connect Wallet, and here you can connect it. You can also create multiple accounts to keep your funds separate. I am going to create the Cryptomarket account. Here at the top, you can choose the one you want to use. Note that when creating a new account, new addresses are also created. However, keep in mind that all the accounts you create, even if they have different addresses, will be linked to the same secret recovery phrase. Here you can also import an account that you have in another wallet. And you can import a private key. This topic of private keys is a more advanced topic. It is when you want to restore a single blockchain. Below, you can add an address, but only to see it and thus monitor its balance and movements. In the Sol scan, I am going to choose a random address. I'm going to use this. I'm going to copy it. Here, I enter the name. For example, if you want to monitor the direction of a project, you can place it here. And here I'm going to paste the address. And look, here appears the balance and the tokens that this address has in Solana. These accounts have an eye icon. And removing it is very easy. You go to Manage Accounts and simply select the account and delete it. Now, I'm going to deposit some funds to show you how the wallet works. I'm going to send them from the OKX exchange. I am going to deposit USDD in the Solana network. I'm going to select Receive. This is very interesting. Here you can see that only the networks appear. This is because in this wallet, you do not have to select the specific token you want to deposit. You just need to copy the network address. So, I'm going to select Solana. Here you can scan the QR code, or you can copy the address. Now, I'm going to the OKX exchange. I already have the USDD token selected. Here I paste the address. And look, the exchange automatically recognizes that the address belongs to the Solana network. I pass the security filter. And that's it. Look that the dollars already appear here in the Solana network. Here, you can see a small icon, which indicates the network each token is on. Remember that to use these decentralized wallets, you must have funds in the networks you're going to use. For example, I deposited USDD into the Solana network. So, in order to move these dollars, I need to have some Solana in my wallet. By selecting this icon, you enter the exchanges section. You can do these exchanges between tokens from the same network, or you can also do them between different networks. For example, if you select USDD that are on the Solana network, you can buy BONK, which is on the same network. Or you can also transfer dollars from the Solana network to the Polygon network. Here you select the USDD on the Polygon network. You must pay attention to the small icons that show which network each token belongs to in order to choose the correct token. Here you enter the amount you want to change. And here the exchange data appears. Here it appears that the exchange is going to be carried out using the Jupiter Decentralized Exchange in Albridge. And here it shows that this is the best price that was found for the exchange. And this refuel option is excellent. Look, the exchanges that are made between networks are known as bridges. And in these exchanges, you have to pay two commissions. In this case, I have to pay a commission to the Solana network and another commission to the Polygon network. Because I am moving the token from one network to the other, I have Solana in my wallet, but look, I don't have Matic in this wallet, so I couldn't make this bridge. But if I do the bridge with this refuel option activated, the wallet allows me to pay while the bridge is being done. During the bridge, from the balance that I have in Solana, the wallet takes a small portion and buys Matic to pay the commissions. When the bridge ends, you'll realize that a little Matic appears in my wallet balance, and I never bought them. Okay, now I'm going to review the order. Here it appears that the estimated time is 2 minutes while the entire operation is executed. And the slippage is 0.5%. Slippage is like insurance that you have when executing exchange. The most common percentages are 0.3% and 0.5%. This means that if while you are making the exchange, the price moves and exceeds that percentage, the exchange is canceled. You can modify these values in the upper right part of the wallet. You must keep in mind that if the value is very low and there is a lot of volatility, the exchanges will be canceled very often. So, it is best to leave it at 0.5%. I'm going to select swap. Dollars on the Polygon network don't appear immediately, so don't panic. As the token is being passed from one network to another, it may take a few seconds to appear in the wallet. And that's it. Here, the dollars appear in the Polygon network and the dollars in the Solana network. Now I'm going to send a few dollars to the OKX exchange using the Solana network to show you how it works. I'm going to OKX and I'm going to copy the address. USDD on the Solana network. It is very important to select the correct network that you are going to use to deposit. And now in the wallet, I am going to select the USDD that has the small Solana icon. I'm going to select send. Here I paste the address. I choose the amount. I'm going to choose the maximum amount. I verify the information and send. And that's it. Now I go to OKX. And the dollars appear here. Look, it is a very easy to use wallet. In this icon on the right, you can navigate through the Solana ecosystem. Here you find the most popular decentralized applications. And finally, if you suddenly lose your seed words for some reason, you can go to this account management section. You enter the password and the wallet shows you the secret recovery phrase again. Well, that's all for this video. I hope you like this information about this wallet. Look, it's very fast, very nice, and very easy to use. If you have any opinion or question, remember that you can leave it in the comments section. And if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video.